Now, up to here, maybe everybody of you have understood whatever we have for the introduction, what we have learned. Okay, so beta, listen it more and more time. Again, I am repeating so that your concept may be clear and understanding the topic. Now, one last thing, positive and negative rational numbers definitions are given in your book. You will note down from there. Examples I have given, I make you with the examples, I make you understand what are the positive rational numbers or negative rational. Again, one more time, I am repeating that if in numerator or denominator anyone is having minus sign, whether the numerator is negative or denominator is negative, then that rational number is known as the negative rational number. Positive rational, I am not writing the definition because already it is given to you. So, you will note down positive and after this rational number, first you will note down the positive and negative rational numbers from your book. Okay, it is given in your book and then you will note down these examples. Okay, then positive rational number, if numerator and denominator both have the same sign, whether both are both positive and if both of them are negative, then those kinds of rational numbers are known as the positive rational number. See that. Now we are coming to the next. Suppose I told you if both of them have same sign, because minus and minus will become cancelled, so what it will become? Positive rational number. What it will become? Positive rational number. Okay, and if both have plus 5 upon plus 7, then also it will be positive rational number. Okay, if minus 5 upon 7 is there, then only one sign is, one is negative, so it will become negative rational number. It will become negative rational number. Maybe everybody of you up to here, your concept will be clear. If minus plus 5 upon minus 7 is there, then also it will become negative rational number. Okay, beta. Now, next thing comes equivalent rational number. What do you mean? Equivalent rational number. Here, up to here, it is clear to you maybe. I am hoping that I have tried to explain you all the things more and more by repeating them so that you will be very clear your concept. Note down all the things in your copy properly and then show me in my WhatsApp number. Okay, now come beta, next thing is equivalent rational number. Okay, rational number definition, because we need this for understanding the concept. Okay, or set of integers also required for that. Equivalent rational number. Equivalent rational numbers means, suppose beta, we are having any example, suppose 4 upon minus 4 upon 5 is there and he is saying you that 5, find the 5 equivalent rational number for this. So how you will do, as we are finding equivalent fraction, same way you have to find. First, I can, for finding equivalent rational number, for equivalent rational numbers, multiply numerator and denominator by same numbers, by same numbers of different values, of different values. For example, first you multiply minus 4 upon 5 by same number, mean 2 upon 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, anything you can say. What it will become? Minus 8 upon 5, 2 to 10. If you will simplify it, again minus 4 upon 5 will come. Next time, minus 4 upon 5, you will multiply it by 3 upon 3, suppose. What it will become? Minus 12 upon 15. Again, if you will simplify, minus 4 upon 5 will come. So, again, suppose if minus 4 upon 5 is here, if you will multiply it by 4 upon 4, what it will be? Minus 16 upon 20. If you will simplify it again, minus 4 upon 5. So all these are known as the equivalent rational numbers. All these are known as the equivalent rational numbers. Now all the things which we need to understand the topic, all the things we have discussed here. Now we are moving to the next thing, that is our exercise part. Now see that beta, what is question number first? List 5 rational numbers between minus 1 and 0. You can see that these are not in the form of P upon Q. So first of all, you will write for the rational number, you know that what form in rational number they should have. They always should have P upon Q, where Q not equal to 0, okay? And P and Q both are integers. Now integers are very clear to you, to everybody of you. I am not writing the set of integers now. How you can make them? By writing that integers are minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on up to here, and here also it will be continued. Okay, now see that its value should not be changed and it should be converted in the form of P upon Q. So what way we can write? We have only one thing. If you will write under one of both the numbers, then there will be no change in the value. So it will be minus 1 upon 1 and next is 0 upon 1. Because 0 upon something, 0 upon any number, it always becomes 0. So there will be 0 in its value. Now we have to, what we will do? We will multiply. Whenever we would like to find the rational numbers between any two numbers, what we will do? Multiply in numerator and denominator by 10, in both the ways. What it will become? Minus 1 upon 1 into 10 upon 10, or here also 0 upon 1 into 10 upon 10. There should be no doubt to any one of you. What it will become? Minus 10 upon 10, and here we will write rational number 10 into 0 means 0 upon 10. Okay, now see beta, if I would like to go from 0, I am making now set of integers in a bigger form so that you may understand. I is equal to minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, minus 10, minus 10, or dash dash dash, there is no limit. Now see that if I will go to minus 10 to 0, minus 10 to 0, if I will go, what I will get? Minus 9. So I can write minus 9 upon 10 will be another number, then minus 8 upon 10 will be another number, then minus 7 upon 10 will be another number, then minus 6 upon 10 will be another, because their denominators are equal, minus 5 upon 10, minus 4 upon 10, minus 3 upon 10, many numbers. You have to write any 5. I have written many more. Again I am having minus 1 upon 10, minus 2 upon 10, so you can select any 5 between them. Okay, in this way it will be your answer. One more part of the question I am doing now, that is D part. And then rest of the part you will perform yourself and show me in your WhatsApp number. Minus 2 and minus 1 is there. First step, what I told you, that change in the form of P upon Q by writing 2 upon 1 and minus 1 upon 1. Then in next step, multiply by 10. Multiply by 10. Okay, these are the steps. So it will become minus 2 upon 1 into 10 upon 10 and minus 1 upon 1 into 10 upon 10. Okay, now see that what it will become on the left side, 10 to the 20, minus 20 upon 10, or here minus 10 upon 10. Okay, now make the number lines so that you may understand. Here it will be, suppose 0, I am not making the right hand side number 0. If I will go here, What will be the numbers on the left side? -1, -2, -3, -4, -5, -6, -7, -8, -9, -10, -11, -12, -13, -14. Okay. -15, -16, -17, -18, -19, or -20. From where to where you have to write? This is -20. Or it is -10. From now, in between many numbers are there. You can select any 5 numbers. I am selecting -18/10, -15/10, -13/10, -11/10, or -17/10. So it can be 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In this way, you can find the rational number between the given number. So, beta, all of you will do the rest of the part of this question, C, D and E part. Maybe everybody of you, if you will see very carefully and attentively, then you will understand how the ma'am is doing. Okay, in first step, what you have to do? First of all, you just make write, because they are not given in the form of P upon Q. So you just write 1/1 in their denominator part. Then in next part, what you will do? Multiply by 10. Multiply by 10, both the numbers. Okay. And then make the number line. Because with the help of number line, it will be very convenient for you in writing. If I can write directly, but if I will write directly, you will not be able to understand. So you can see that we -20 to -10, we are having lot of numbers. So write under 10, 10, 10, because in your denominator part, you have 10. Okay. So in this way, you will get the rational number between any two numbers. Give the rational numbers equivalent to 4/5. Just now, in the previous part, I taught you how we will make the rational numbers equivalent to 4/5. You select any numbers, and how many rational number? Give three equivalent rational number you have found. What you will do? I have selected multiply. It depends on your choice. Any number you can select. Multiply 2, 3, and 5. Okay, I am multiplying. By multiplying 2, 3, and 5, I am finding their equivalent. First, I will multiply 4/5, multiply by 2/2. What it will be? 4 to the 8, 5 to the 10. It is first equivalent rational number. It will become first equivalent rational number. Okay, then second times I am multiplying by 4/5 by 3/3. So 4 3 12, 5 3 15, it will be second equivalent rational number. Okay, third times I am multiplying 4/5, means numerator and denominator should be multiplied by the same number. Numerator and denominator will be multiplied by the same number, not by the different number. If you multiply by the different numbers na beta, then they will not be counted as a equivalent rational number. Now see that next one, 4/5 multiplied by 5/5. 4 5 ja 20, upon 5 5 ja 25, it will be your third equivalent rational number. Third equivalent rational. In this way, you have given rest of the fractions also. So, apart from this, next time you can multiply by 6, 7 and 8, or 3, 5 or 7, or 4, 3 or 1. It depends on your choice. It depends on your choice that which number you are selecting for the multiplying. By any number, if you will multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number, then they will become equivalent rational number. Thank you for up to here, and then we will start from the next question.